Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick, your absolutely most favorite brother from another mother. Hope you guys are all doing all right today. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's worship him. Let's worship him. Hallelujah, Father, we praise you. Yes, Lord God, we worship you. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord, our Lord God on high. Hallelujah. Let's worship him. And I worship you, O mighty God. There is none like you. Tell him. Oh, I worship you, O Prince of Peace. That is what I long to do. And I give you praise, for you are my righteousness. Hallelujah. Worship him, worship him, praise him. Hallelujah. You got to get under the spot where the glory comes out. Hallelujah. For the Spirit of the Lord inhabits the praises of his people. Hallelujah. As we minister unto the Lord, as we minister unto him, he responds to us, brothers and sisters, as we lift up our voices unto heaven. Hallelujah. Shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Shout unto God with a voice of praise. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord God Most High. Hallelujah. The name of the Lord is a strong tower, and the righteous run into it, and they are saved. Hallelujah. All those songs, a lot of those songs that you hear, they're Bible verses. All those things I said are songs that some of you might know, and they're also Bible verses. You know, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into him, and they are saved. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord up on high. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into him, and they are saved. Hallelujah. Bless his name. Glory and blessing and honor and praise be unto our God. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, I've just been talking to the Lord, and the Lord was just talking to me about fire. You know, the glory, the fire of his glory, the fire of his righteousness, the fire of his holiness. Hallelujah. The Lord is just setting a fire in his people, that the bride, those five wise virgins who would have enough oil to make it, God is setting a fire in us. Let's just worship him. Let's just praise him. Hallelujah. Yes, tell him. Tell him he's great. Hallelujah. Great are you, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Cry to him, hallelujah. Great are you, Lord. Hallelujah, he's great and greatly to be praised. Bless his holy name, brothers and sisters. You got to bless his holy name, hallelujah, while he is near. I want to read a Bible passage to you that the Lord just, you know, laid on me. From Zephaniah chapter 2. Gather yourselves together, ye... yea, gather together, O nation not desired. That's Israel, of course. Before the decree, bring forth, before the day pass as the chaff, before the fierce anger of the Lord come upon you, before the day of the Lord's anger come upon you, seek ye the Lord, all ye meek of the earth, which have wrought his judgment. Seek righteousness, seek meekness. It may be ye shall be hid in the day of the Lord's anger. And the Lord just gave me this text right before I started making the video. I didn't even read over it. The Lord told me, Zephaniah chapter 2. I just opened it up and found it, read the first verse, started making this video. Listen to this. It's about the rapture. I didn't even know. Seek ye the Lord, all ye meek of the earth, which have wrought his judgment, have worked his judgment. That's those who have been doing God's what God sees as right. Seek righteousness, seek meekness. It may be ye shall be hid. It may be ye shall be hid in the day of the Lord's anger. talking about during the tribulation. It goes on and on and on about it, all about Israel and all that. Those verses right there, brothers and sisters, are from the Lord. That's a rhema word. Logos is the Greek word for the Bible, the Word of God. Jesus is the Logos, the Word of God. And then a rhema is a word from the Word, an illuminated word from the Word. You know, a lot of times you've heard me say, you know, people say they got a revelation from the Lord, but actually, you know, we don't get new revelation. That's like writing the Bible. We get illumination. God would illuminate by a rhema word something from the Word of God within the context of the Bible. That's a great example, brothers and sisters. I just read the text right now that the Lord had given to me, and it connects right to what I'm talking about. Praise God, praise God, that the Lord would hide us. What does he say to do there? Let me get the text back here. What does he say to do? From the Old Testament, of course. The thing about the Bible, brothers and sisters, it is a continuing revelation. In other words, God didn't expect the people in the Old Testament to know about Jesus. You know, it was hidden in there. So the Bible is a progressive revelation. So in other words, you know, like in the Old Testament, people had a bunch of wives and stuff. You know, God told us from the beginning, you know, that Adam and Eve became one flesh. There was only Adam and Eve. The type that God set was one man and one woman, and they became one flesh. But then under the law of Moses, Jesus said, because of the hardness of the hearts of the people, the Lord allowed them, Moses gave them the authority to divorce their wives, to do a decree of divorce. But Jesus said it was not so from the beginning. And he quoted back there where the two would become one flesh. So it's supposed to be one man and one woman, not multiple wives. But God didn't correct them in the Old Testament. God is slowly, if you read the Bible from the very beginning, God slowly introduces and corrects them and brings it all the way forward to the elevation of where you get that, you know, the manifestation of the Son of God, Jesus Christ, comes in the fullness of times, it says. In the fullness of times, Jesus was born, and in the fullness of the time of the Gentiles, the rapture will happen. The Lord will return in the fullness of times again, brothers and sisters. What does he tell us to do here? Gather yourself together, ye O nation not desired. You know, there's double meaning on that first verse I'm just thinking about. Well, you know, Christians, we've been rejected in the world. Like in the beginning of the church age, even as I'm thinking so fast here. And in Ecclesiastes, King Solomon says, as it was in the beginning, so it'll be at the end. So in the end, so it shall be in the beginning. You know, there's nothing new under the sun. And so in the beginning of the church age, the Christians were fed to the lions and all that stuff and rejected. And then we had a period where the church and state became one. The supposed church, okay, not many real Christians. There were some real Christians all along, but the church became the state, and the state became the church, a.k.a. the Dark Ages, a.k.a., you know, the Roman Catholic Empire through the Middle Ages and all that, you know, from 500-600 A.D. until 1500 A.D. approximately, okay. Then it began the restoration of the bride, restoration of the church, the Reformation began in those days and still going to the culmination of the rapture. Is the culmination of that restoration. So in the beginning of the church age, we had great persecution. We had holiness and righteousness and sanctification and power of God, speaking in tongues, the gifts of the Spirit, healing, raising dead, all that in the beginning of the church age. And so is it coming back in the end of the church age, brothers and sisters. Those few, just like in the beginning, there were few. Can you imagine that when Jesus was seen, Paul tells us that more than 500 people saw the resurrected Christ at one time. The Lord appeared many times during those 40 days after his resurrection. There were 40 days that he appeared. And at one of those appearances, over 500 people saw him in one time. But yet in the upper room, there was only 120 brothers and sisters that received the baptism of the Holy Spirit, that received the manifestation of the power of God. You know, the Holy Spirit was given, the Comforter, another Comforter, Jesus said, was given to the church, the Holy Spirit. Given to the church that day, and then when that restrainer, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, when that restrainer, that is the Holy Spirit operating through the church, is removed from this earth, when we go up, the Holy Spirit indwelling those Christians, real Christians, we're going to be called up to meet the Lord in the air, the rapture. That's when the restrainer will be removed. That's when the Antichrist comes forward. But gather yourselves together. So a double meaning on this text right here that the Lord is just illuminating in my mind and giving me a rhema word on it as I'm speaking to you. A word of wisdom here. O ye nation not desired. Of course, it's talking about Israel. But guess what? The church has also. I keep talking to Brother Gary about this when we talk on the phone. And I don't think I've been mentioning it in the videos much. The main theme when me and Gary are talking, because Gary's always talking about Israel. And then I'm talking about the church. The Israel is the natural manifestation. So the natural nation that is not desired is Israel, but the spiritual nation that's not desired, that peculiar people, you know, a holy nation, that's the church. A people that were not a people, but God calls them a people, the Bible says. That's the church, to provoke Israel to jealousy. We're the spirit. We're the spiritual seed of Abraham, adopted sons of God. Israel is the natural seed of Abraham. Everything you look at, God's natural sign on earth is Israel and Jerusalem. God's spiritual sign on earth is the church. I could go on and on and on about that. I can't remember if I've made videos about that. I probably mentioned it a little bit, but one of the biggest themes the Lord keeps giving me is that. And then I talked to Gary about it because he's doing the natural Israel side and I'm doing the spiritual church side. I never keep forgetting to mention it in videos, or the Lord hasn't led me to talk about it, put it that way. So we are the spiritual and the duality of this first verse. This is Zephaniah chapter 2, verse 1. Gather yourselves together, ye. Gather together, O nation not desired. Israel's been rejected, despised and rejected of men. Jesus was despised and rejected of men. We are his body. The natural Jesus, when he walked the earth, he came to his own, but his own received him not. That's Israel. He was in among his brethren, the nation of Israel. But now he was rejected, and after his resurrection, all those who are born again, we are his brethren. He's firstborn from the dead among many brethren. That's us, the church. We are his spiritual brethren. Israel is his natural brethren. We'll become one new man and come together when the Lord returns, when we'll all be united. Israel and the church will be united there in the millennial reign of Christ. You know, we'll all be one new man there. When Israel accepts the Messiah, as it says, all Israel will be saved in one day. Romans chapter 9 and 11, we see that Israel will be restored. But in the meantime, it's also talking about the church. It's amazing how the Lord can give you a whole sermon out of one verse. I'm still on the first verse. Verse 2, before the decree. What's the decree? The Daniel, you know, he'll confirm a covenant with many. That's the decree. Bring forth before the day passes as chaff, before the fierce anger of the Lord come upon you. You know, the decree, they're going to confirm the seven-year covenant, but God's decree is going to go out. That's the, you know, the unveiling. The word revelation is, you know, in the Greek, is the apocalypsis and apocalypse, the unveiling of Christ. It's the revelation, the revealing of Jesus Christ. It's not the revelation of something Jesus is telling, but the literal title of the book, Revelation, is the revealing of the Lord Jesus Christ to the world. He's already been revealed to those who have an ear to hear and eyes to see, the church. But he's going to be unveiled to the whole world, even those who do not have an eye to see or ears to hear spiritually. He will reveal himself to them, and every nation will see him. Every eye will see him, and every nation will mourn because they have rejected the Christ. That's at the second coming, at the end of the age, at the end of the seven-year tribulation period. Before the decree, so before that, before the tribulation, bring forth, before the day passes, before the fierce anger of the Lord come upon you, before the day of the Lord's anger come upon you, seek ye the Lord, all ye meek of the earth, which have wrought his judgment, have worked his judgment. Seek righteousness, seek meekness. It may be you shall be hid in the day of the Lord's anger. Brothers and sisters, seek that. As I always tell you guys from the New Testament verse, God gives grace to the humble, but he resists the proud. I think that's also quoted out of the Old Testament. Brothers and sisters, we must humble ourselves before the Lord. Humble ourselves and seek his face while he may be found, as it says back there. I believe that is Isaiah 58, maybe 55. It says, you know, God's arm is not too short that he can't reach down, or his ear deaf that he cannot hear. You know, seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Hallelujah. This church age, this age of grace. Brothers and sisters, we are at the end, just at the very end, the last twilight moments of the church age. This hour of grace, this hour of mercy, this time of jubilee. People keep talking about the natural. That's the problem with all these Christians and all this Judaizing, carnal-minded people who are not appointed by God, who are on YouTube making videos, you know, wearing a yarmulke, trying to speak Hebrew, and people think they're Hebrew scholars, and they're not. And people think they know what they're talking about, but they don't. They're talking carnal minded, talking flesh, and they don't even know how to rightly, you don't even know what you're talking about, rightly dividing the word of God. Brothers and sisters, the jubilee that Jesus is referring to is the church age. The church age. This is the spiritual year of jubilee we are in right now. Now, there's going to be the millennial reign of Christ too, but right now we are in the year of jubilee where all debts can be forgiven, where all things are restored unto what you have, you know, what you've lost be restored unto you. How? Through the blood of Jesus Christ, through the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach in Hebrew, through the blood of the Messiah. can you receive and be restored. All things lost can be regained through Christ. Right now, right now, you can, this very day, this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Today is the day of salvation. Hallelujah. Today is acceptable day. That's the text right there, what it says. This is the acceptable day of the Lord. Now, Jesus, when he quoted from that text, talking about that from Isaiah 62:61, he says, you know, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to open the eyes of blind. It's there in Luke 4:16. And Jesus stops right there. He says, in the acceptable year of the Lord. He stopped. The next verse in Isaiah 61 in the Old Testament says, "The preach the acceptable year of the Lord and the year of vengeance of our God." Now, brothers and sisters, the year of vengeance of our God is the tribulation. So Jesus stopped. There's a gap. That's why in the 70 weeks of Daniel, oh, Lord God, thank you for your wisdom. Let me divide this word of all this nonsense you might have heard on YouTube that has nothing to do with theology, nothing to do with the Word of God, and nothing to do with rightly dividing the Word of God. There are 70 weeks of the 70 weeks of Daniel. Brothers and sisters, there's already been 69 weeks. The 69th week ceased. The count ceased from the decree to rebuild Israel at the beginning of the 70 weeks. The 69th week ceased on the day that Jesus rode into Jerusalem on Palm Sunday, the beginning of the what we call the Passion Week, the Passion of the Christ. The clock stopped. When Israel rejected their king, God stopped the clock. That's why the tribulation is also called the 70th week of Daniel, the time of Jacob's trouble. This is what I said, the year of vengeance of our God, Yahweh's strange work, all these different names from the Old Testament, for that one last week. And in this time period, that's what we call the age of grace, the church age, the dispensation of Jubilee. Now, I've mentioned this in videos before, and someone messaged me and said, oh, are you saying the year 2014 is a year of Jubilee? He who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit said through the Bible 2,000 years ago in plain, simple language, translated into all languages of the world. The Messiah said that he came to set the captives free, open the eyes of blind, preach liberty to those who are bound, and to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. That word right there from the Old Testament back there in Isaiah 61 is the year of Jubilee. We have been in the year of Jubilee. All those who humble themselves and receive the grace of God through the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach, through the stripes of Jesus, become healed, through the blood of Jesus, be set free, to be delivered from all things of hell, death, and the grave, the world, the flesh, and the devil, been set free by the blood of the Lamb of God, slain from the foundation of the world. We have been in that year of Jubilee. It is Jubilee for all who will receive the Jubilee through the blood of Yeshua. Hallelujah. It's not a year in the spirit, brothers and sisters, but the church age. And that age is about to become to an end. That's what I'm trying to convey to you. While you can seek the Lord, seek him now. For the day is coming when nighttime comes, as Jesus said, and no man can work. No man can work. Darkness cometh in that can be felt, cometh in like a flood, and they shall not escape, the Bible tells us. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, darkness is coming, and these people will not escape. It even says there in 2 Thessalonians, people love to keep quoting from that, trying to say that the church will be here when the Antichrist is revealed. As I just read for you the text, further down in that chapter, it says that the restrainer will be removed before the Antichrist can come forward. That restrainer is the Holy Spirit through the church. It also tells us, brothers and sisters, in that very same text, if you read that text, it says, because the people have chosen to believe a lie instead of the truth, God, not the devil, God will send them strong delusion that they shall believe. The text says, in the King James, it says a lie. But the original text says the lie. They will believe the lie of the Antichrist. What is that lie? What is that lie? The lie is that we're all gods, truthfully. The Antichrist will declare himself to be God, and he will tell us we're all gods. Go listen to the New Age people and see what they say. They'll say that I am. Just like Joel Osteen just wrote a book saying how to be, you know, the best I am and all, or whatever. You know, I am this and I am that. He's got a sermon about it. I posted it on Facebook the other day. This comes from Oprah Winfrey and Shirley MacLaine and all these other people. Goes all the way back, brothers and sisters. Here's a clue, a simple clue. How do we know Mormonism is a cult and is from the devil? Mormonism teaches if you follow their teachings and do great, good works, you will become a god. God was a man who lived on a planet. He did a great job and became a god. Jesus did a great job and became a god. You too can become a god. Brothers and sisters, it's so simple. Go back and read Genesis chapter 3. You will see that Satan told Eve, the serpent. The Bible tells us the serpent, the dragon, the devil, Satan, they're all the same thing. He told Eve that if you eat that fruit, you'll become as God. And your eyes will be open and you'll be like God. That's the exact same thing the Antichrist is going to tell people. That's what the Mormons tell people. That's what the New Age tells people. It's always that the inner God, the Christ consciousness, all these things. That's the devil's message. That is the lie, that you are a God and you can become a God when you take that mark. You'll become actually a Giborim. You'll become one of the Giborim. You'll be a Gibor, one of the Giborim, a mighty man, like what Nimrod did. Talked about that way back before. That's what happened when you take the mark. You will become a changed DNA. You'll become a Nephilim if you take the mark. Brothers and sisters, let's don't be here when it happens. Let's get raptured. Let's get right with Christ. God bless you all.